Hi there and welcome back to the Floss Marketing School. In this video, we are going to see how you can install Odoo CRM ERP on a real server. So I decided to make this video because Lucas gave me a lot of help in order to set Odoo on my own server. And as a result, I just wanted to explain you how it works. So the first thing that you need to do, of course, is to access to your server. So you just go in SSH, okay, on your server, and then you need to create a folder. So you can name it whatever you want. You can just name it Odoo, okay? So you just mkdir and Odoo. Then you need, of course, to enter within this given folder, and you need as well to get on the official documentation of Docker, because we are going to get the Docker compose file, which is the configuration file needed in order to use a Docker image. And by chance, there is an official image for Odoo, which means that actually you can easily deploy Odoo on your server without, let's say, getting headaches. So when you go on registry.hub.docker, blah, 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 you get here down below, you get a file. So you get different files. They have simple one and complicated one. The one that I used is this one. So you just copy and paste all this part. And as you can see here, it's telling the port which is going to be used. It's going to give you information about the credential for the database and everything that you need in terms of dependency in order to have your whole project running. So you create a file which is called docker compose dot yaml file, and then once you do it, so you create it with nano, so nano docker compose yaml, and once you have it, of course, you save it, and once you save it, you stay within the folder in where you are, so in the folder name Odoo in my case, and then you perform sudo docker compose up d, so it will create your Docker Odoo image. Hub means that it's going to be active, and D means that it's not going to continue to use your terminal, so you will have your terminal free. Okay, once you have this, it means that you have Odoo running, but then you need to have your domain name as well, on which you will host your on which you will make it Odoo accessible. So you need to perform, if you are on Apache, sudo certbot cert only d, and then followed by your domain name in order to have your SSL certificate. And then you need to go within slash etc slash apache 2 slash sites available, where you create a .conf file. So you can call it like odoo .conf file, and here you copy and paste those lines. So within those lines, you need here to change it by the domain name that you would like to use. You need as well to add this line in order to forward the different the HTTP to the HTTPS version. Then here you need to change the port and have the same port as the one that you use in your Docker compose file, and so on and so forth. So you need as well to change it over here, your domain name, same thing here for the port. And then once it's created, then you need to activate it by sudo site your config file.conf, and then you need to restart Apache 2. Once you have all of this done, you need to access to your URL where you decided to install Odoo, so to say your domain name. And if it does not work, if you get kind of a strange messages, then you can just perform, so you go back on your folder Odoo, and then you perform docker compose exec web bash. In fact, this workaround has been described over here in this given github.com ticket, because the seems like the Docker image file is not perfect. And then you just perform this given line of code when you are within your container, and once you are finished, you can just exit your container by just pressing Ctrl C, or just to type exit, and then you should be fine. So it means that then you will access to this given page with, of course, the credential that you will have used before. So those credentials will be either the one which are within your Docker Compose file, so either those credentials that you can find over here, or either the one that you would have created once you go for the first time on the domain name. So they will ask you for the identifier that you want to use, or the password, and once you get in, this you can just access to the marvelous world of Odoo, and you can start to play and install every component that you have. And that's it for today, so hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.